unsportsmanlike conduct will be tolerated. Good luck to you both.
And coming off a fight, fellas, as we start round number one, all my life, in his words, never been down in the third round of his last fight. First time, Lennox, that he's...
I'd rather get knocked down in the gym.
And I know, Joe, you were calling that fight with us.
Yeah.
You said he was winning that fight clearly and had Kaladze. You know, he was able to come back and stop his man, do the whole thing. He looked great, but...
Well, head movement. He's looking to move his head more. Just like the guy a lot over and over again. Sometimes they don't work.
Learning on the job. He only started boxing at 17. He played to not leave him be and would not leave his friends be. And a dream fight against a...
That's right. Now, Ajagba is really starting with his jab. And now, please... just look at him.
Sees the initiative, of right hand fired back by. Ajagba looks comfortable moving forward.
Here you see a great body shot by Ajagba.
My gym a few times, but right now I think he just wants to make it through these.
Down in the knockout by Ajagba, so he was able to finish the deal. But
yeah, exactly.
And
yeah,
here's the jab. This is the jab that he has.
You know, Henry Tillman, who's in the corner to force him out of that. Cojanu, much more aggressive away that right hand. They say, hey, when you take that away, what's left?
Right now. And Tillman probably saw something that...
It's got to make Ajagba a little more uncomfortable. That was uncomfortable.
By backing up the guy that wants
Ajagba to really be more focused right now.
Really has shown a great aptitude for the sport. Started boxing at 17. He won a gold medal at the African Games in 2015.
You know, Ajagba throws a good 1-2, and he just finally went to a knockdown for the Kaladze fight. But I know
hands up nice and high, protecting himself. This is where, you know, Ajagba...
Not that don't have titles.
It was like 60 wins versus, you know, like...
He's Ortiz, who really tested Deontay Wilder, and then the up-and-coming Daniel Dubois. He won his last fight.
Yeah.
But he was fighting at the highest level. He lost to Joseph Parker. Not much effect.
A lot of what Cojanu's doing, man.
And he said he stood close to... That is an illegal move, though, Joe. Correct me if I'm wrong.
The
black trunks with the red trim. That is F.A. Ajagba. Larry Hazard with us as well. Round three. Italy, Romania, now living in Monte Carlo. And this was 20 shots already in this round in the opening minute. Another one.
Yeah. I can tell you that.
Ajagba with another good...
Very
protect yourself at all times.
Yeah, of course. But...
Ronnie Shields, we saw him.
Warner, you know, told him to go to the body and come back up with that left.
Like top 10 opponents next year.
I mean, based on the fact that he's now just started on his season, and I think dedication as well.
Good
and he's given a few more fights, he's going to be ready to take on it.
See, what Ajagba does very well is...
With the jab there to the body, but that's a nice little scoring shot. I think Sanchez, who's been boxing most of his life, which one of these, you know, young heavyweights who started late.
Forearm, Ajagba against the rope, and then used him. He's getting a little courage worked up right now. He's starting to fall.
Effective those punches already on Cojanu's face. It's a flash right in the black trunks. Right here in Brooklyn. That's our main event. It's coming up next.
Talk about it a little bit more. The guy's getting tired, but...
Concentrated and focused here tonight. What did you tell him going into... Excellent. Thanks, Ronnie. Brian, back to you.
Heidi, thank you. Steps up. It's only his 13th professional fight.
What a job.
He only had that very active round, too. It's not like he...
Second win. Get your second win.
And fighting hit is very important at this stage. Getting hit with silly shots. He's definitely got to keep his head
on Ajagba if he wants to get something done here. Rounds.
And I like what Ajagba is doing. He's got to be
so right there, bro. Here comes, he's setting up the jab. There's that little gloves there. Well, yeah, that was a good shot.
Able in seconds of the fourth round. Scheduled for 10. And again, Nigeria, Romania, Cuba. This is truly an international event here tonight. Good round. Headlock applied by Cojanu. A beautiful spot as we start. And get back to this round five here for F.A. Ajagba. Does not like heights. And in fact, only two people did. Ajagba and our own Joe Goose.
Yeah, I'm guilty.
Do they not? We'll get out of this. Heidi.
Thank you very much, Brian. Second round. What are you seeing that you want him to do more of?
He threw the right hand with the left hook behind it.
Excellent. Thank you.
He was he got by Mike Tyson twice in 5 and 6, but that is, again, that's quite in history.
Ajagba has to really...
Ajagba wants to jump forward.
Yeah. Correct.
That to Razvan, Cojanu. It looks like Cojanu is actually getting them. You know, see, like that. You know, tied up or tie up, but they use when he gets in close, he's got to lift the body and head. He just moves. Yes. Now the body's shot. There you go. Now, here's what I don't like. That's, you know, it wasn't a...
Do an awful lot more. Good body work there. Just tapping him, and you can take a point away.
I don't like it. It's a dangerous thing.
Ron, look.
Protect you, and your brainstem is back there, and believe me.
Into the body in this fight. And that's kind of a moving attack. So, actually... reasonably close. Forget about getting hit in the back of the head. I didn't see that. Kind of cuffing with that.
Any punches of his own.
And there's a big difference between, like, the side of the head. Big difference there, and then hitting a man on the back of.
Go over there. Unintentional low blow.
Call it an
unintentional.
Cojanu staggered by that, comes back and fires and slaps a right. And that happens with things.
And if you punch. Oh. Well, he's got his head pulled down, so Ajagba juggler on the back of the head.
Straight up the middle.
Down. I mean, that is not a rabbit.
Listen, I was never good amount of power with a right hook.
Cojanu here in the final seconds.
Very consistent. He's kind of...
When he's inspired, he's a fairly dangerous guy.
Yeah, it's inconsistent. Okay, and here we go. There's that little chopper around.
Hook, left hook. Right hook.
The black trunks. Let's go to Larry Hazard. Larry, every round?
Every.
Ajagba landed a fight-high 33 punches. Trunks with the red trim. Cojanu there in.
You know, you can't give a guy a round because he fights. Ajagba's putting on a clinic with this guy. One of those body shots and we can go. Every round. I'm just waiting for him to sit down. On.
And Cojanu will get angry and then start fighting. He's right in a consistent attack from Ajagba.
That's exactly right, as usual. And while we were assessing things, but the combination, a 4 or 5 punch combination, and for a good one landed, but Cojanu took it down again. Left up with that right hand when you were talking. And I think the
Larry jabs and right hands right away. He's up next to him. That is a lot of weight pulling against each other.
Gets to the cushion. There is no cushion.
Body work there by Cojanu as he gets the
sharp punches. He can use short little punches, short little combinations. That's
6 months ago, so their lives have changed. And we have heavyweight news coming. Joe Goosen is somehow involved in all this, Joe Goosen.
For the unveiling. You know?
The big reveal against Razvan Cojanu.
You know, I got to give him a lot of credit.
Razvan
on the left side. Well, you know, he turned southpaw for a second. I thought, joke. Sorry if I even brought it up.
Right. Southpaw phobia.
See, rights and lefts. They're just in very different places.
Oh!
Give me your gloves. Oh, okay. So to show me something. Box.
Try for a last hurrah here.
Another right hand beating. He's game, and another combination straight up the middle. Cojanu could defend himself, and that is really... Cojanu is game, and we're saying, come on.
He wants a knockout here. He doesn't want another distance fight like we're in kind of beat, and there it was.
Just as he is trying to wrestle and keep Ajagba at bay. The right hand. Cojanu's body language is not good. See the swelling over that right eye.
Doing anything right now.
No, not even throwing punches. Look. Good jab, snaps the head.
Against Lipton to let the fight go on, but... Yeah,
nice count
on another knockout on his record. So
jab backs up Cojanu again. You see the jab snap. Let's try it again. And now right hands over the top.
Where it ends with an uppercut, and he'll have really good significance. Ajagba.
Yeah, that
by Ajagba.
You can't. Ajagba cannot get lazy in here.
Punches at him, but Ajagba's back to the rope.
This is where Ajagba needs to step to the side and show that.
But careful. Winding up, Robert, but you look at the body language from Cojanu. Not good right now. He takes the knee. He's just had too much, and it's over.
That's it.
He waved it off.
Ron Lipton has waved it off. It's over. F.A. Ajagba beat Hitkins in round number 9. A referee in charge stops the contest. He is the winner by way of technical knockout. He is still undefeated. The one and only F.A. Ajagba.